Hello everyone, welcome back to the online classes. In earlier lessons, lesson 1 and lesson 2, you have learned about numerals, the number names, the whole numbers, the natural numbers, etc. Now with that only, we'll continue with lesson number 3, playing numbers for standard 6th. Now, in this chapter, first we'll start with the factors and multiples. Factors and multiples already in your earlier classes you have studied. So just we'll go through it. Now first, factors. A number which divides a given number exactly is called a factor, or a given number or a factor of a number is an exact divisor of that number. Exact, now you know the tables and all. So regarding that, where the factors have to be done. Or you can say in simple words that supposing I take the example 15, the F15, in which tables it comes, that table is known as the factor of that given number. Now your example 15. Now 15 is exactly divisible by, now so 15 divided by, now supposing first your 15 divided by 15 is equal to 1. So 1 is the factor. Next, you can divide 15 divided by 3 is equal to 5. So this is the exact divisible. If you divide this number, there is no remainder, it is 0. So 3 is exactly divisible by 5. So this 3 is known as the factor. Here 15 is exactly divisible by 15, so 1 is the factor over here. Same way, now if you are confused that in this way to find out the factors, there is another way method to find out the factors. Now example, I'll take the next example 20. First you can take 1. First 1 is always the factor of each and every given number. So 1 into 20 is equal to 20. Next after 1, the next table is 2. So 2 multiplied by 10 is equal to 20. Next, in 3 table you do not get, in table of 3 we do not get 20. Now in 4, for table of 4, 4 multiplied by 5 is equal to 20. So here after 5 already you have got all the factors over here. So here the factors for 20 is equal to 1, then you can take it in this manner, U shape. So 1, 2, 4, 5, 10 and 20. These are the factors of 20. Same way here also for 15. Factors of 15 is equal to 1, 3, 5 and 15. These are the factors. I hope you understood the how to find out the factors. Now next we come to multiples. The multiples, the given number is called the multiple of exact of each of its factors. Now here, now we know already about the factors. So here 8 multiplied by 1. So 8 ones are 8. Next factor you take 2. 8 twos are 16. Next you take 8 multiplied by 3. 24. 8 multiplied by 4. 32. 8 multiplied by 5. 40. So here this number, every number is the multiple of itself. So now here 8 ones are 8, 8 twos are 16. So the multiples of 8 is equal to 8, 16, 24, 32, 40 and so on. So there are infinite number of multiples. These numbers continuously keep on going. So there is no end. Now the smallest multiple is always the given number itself. So here now the multiples are 8, 16, 24, 32, 40 and so on. It will go on. So or in a simple word you can say the tables, whichever number is given, the table of that given number are the multiples. Now next we come to the perfect number. A number of for which the sum of all its factors are equal to twice the number is called the perfect number. Now for example, factors of 6. So factors of 6 are 6, 1, 2, 3, and 6. So if you add up these numbers, that is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 6. So it is 12. So that is twice. 6 multiplied by 2 is equal to 12. So now here it is the double of. Now the given number is 6. So the factors of 6, if you add it up, you get the double of this number. So 6 is the perfect number. Now next we come to even numbers. Even numbers, a number which is exactly divisible by 2 is called even numbers. That is example. Now any number whose unit place is 2 and is divisible by 2, that numbers are called the even numbers. Example 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and so on. These are called the even numbers. Same way odd numbers. A number which is not divisible, not exactly divisible by 2 are called odd numbers. That the numbers like 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, so on. These numbers are known as the odd numbers. Now we continue with prime numbers. Now natural numbers greater than 1, which has no factors except 1 and the number itself, are called the prime numbers. The numbers which has no factors except 1 and the number itself, those numbers are known as prime numbers. Example 2, 3, 5, 7, 11. These numbers are not divisible by any other number except 1. So these numbers are known as prime numbers. Next we have composite numbers. The numbers having more than 2 factors are called composite numbers. Example 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, 12, etc. So on. Now for example 4. So 4 has more factors. 1, 2 and 4. So this way the numbers we are having more than 2 factors are known as composite numbers. Next we come to twin prime numbers. Now pairs of prime numbers which have a difference of 2 are called twin prime numbers. Difference means you have to subtract. After subtracting there should be the difference of 2 numbers. Now example I take 3 and 5. These 2 are prime numbers. If you subtract 5 from 3, the difference is 2. Same way 5 and 7, the difference is 2. Same way 11 and 13, the difference is 2. So such prime numbers where the difference is 2, this type of numbers are known as twin prime numbers. Now how do we find the prime numbers and composite number? Here I made a table of prime numbers between 1 to 50. Now when we start with prime numbers, now 1 is neither prime nor composite. It is known as a special number. Because always the factor and multiple of any number is 1 itself. Now here number 2. Second is a prime number. It has no other divisible. It is divisible by itself alone and 1 is the factor. So it has only 2 factors. So this is a prime number. This 2 is only the one even number which is a prime number. Rest all the prime numbers when you go through, you see all the prime numbers are odd numbers except 2. Now next is 3. 3 is also a prime number. Next 4. 4 has more than 2 factors. So 4 is a composite number. Again 5 is a prime number. 6 is a composite number. 7 is a prime number. Again 8 is a composite number. It has more than 2 factors. 9 also is a composite number. 10 also a composite number. These numbers have more than 2 factors. Again 11 is a prime number. 12 again composite number. Then 13 again is a prime number. 14 again is a composite number. 15 is a composite number. 16 is a composite number. 17 is a prime number. Again 18 is a composite number. 19 is a prime number. 20 is a composite number. Then again 21 is a composite number. 22, 23 is a prime number. Again 24 is a composite number. 25 is a composite number. 26 is a composite number. 27 is a composite number. 28 is a composite number. 29 is a prime number. 30 is a composite number. Again, 31 is a prime number, 32 composite, 33 composite, 34 composite, 35 composite, 36 composite. Now, 37 is a prime number, 38 composite, 39, 40. Then again, 41 is a prime number, 42 composite, 43 is a prime number, 44 composite, 45 composite, 46 composite. Again, 47 is a prime number, 48 composite, 49 composite and 50 composite. These numbers which have marked as cross, these all are composite numbers, means they have more than two factors. The numbers which are in circle, these all are prime numbers which has only two factors. So in this manner you can form a table and write prime numbers between 1 to 100 in your class workbook. Next we come to the test for the divisibility of the numbers. Here we will learn the divisibility test for 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 10 and 11. Now here first we'll start with the divisibility test for 2. Now any number which has the unit place as 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. So that number will be considered as divisible by 2. Now for example, here I have taken the number 234. Now 4 in the unit space is 4. 4 is divisible by 2. So it is said to be 234 is divisible by 2. Next we come to divisibility test for 3. Now the sum of the digits is multiple of 3, then the number is said to be divisible by 3. Now your example 990. Now if you add the digits of 990, that is 9 plus 9 plus 0 is equal to 18. Now the number 18 is a multiple of 3, so it is said that 990 is divisible by 3. Next we come to divisibility test for 4. Now here, if the number formed by the last two digits, that is the tens and the units place, is divisible by 4, then that number is said to be the whole number is said to be divisible by 4. Now here, for example, I've taken 572. So the last two digits, that is the units place and the tens place, is 72. To see if 72 is divisible by 4. 72 divided by 4. So here, if you want, you can divide and check it this way. Now 4 ones are 4. Now here you can see by dividing 4 divided by 72 you get 18. So this number is said to be, that is 572 is said to be divisible by 4. Now next we come to divisibility test by 5. Now, any number which has the unit place either 5 or 0, that number is said to be divisible by 5. Now, for example, 255, the unit place is 5. So, this number is said to be divisible by 5. Another example, I take 220. Here, 0 is the unit place. So, 0 is also divisible by 5. So, here 220 is also divisible by 5. Next we come to the divisibility test for 6. Now here, if the given number is divisible by both, it should be divisible by 2 and 3, then only the number is said to be divisible by 6. Here I have taken example 1278. Now here first we will check whether it is divisible by 2. Now for divisible by 2, we have to see the units place. Now the units place is 8. So 8 is divisible by 2. Therefore 1278 is divisible by 2. Now divisible by 3. Now for divisible by 3. Now if you have to, for divisibility for 3, we have to add the digits. That is 1 plus 2 plus 7 plus 8. 10, 17, 18. Now 18. Again 8 is divisible by 3. So it is said to be that 1278 is divisible by 6, because it is divisible by both 2 and 3. If any number is not divisible by either 2 or either by 3, then that number is not said to be divisible by 6. It has to be divisible by both 2 and 3. Then only the number is said to be divisible by 6. Next we come divisibility test for 8. Now as we had done in 4, same way here also, if the number formed by the last 3 digits, but in 8 we have last 3 digits, that is the units place, tens place and hundreds place, is divisible by 8. So here I have taken example for 14,560. Now the last 3 digits is 560. Now we have to see whether the 560 is divisible by 8. So if you divide, you get 70. So here it is divisible by 8. So this number, that is 14,560, is said to be divisible by 8. Now next is divisibility test for 9. Now the sum, like 3 here also, if the sum of the digits is the multiple of 9, then the number is said to be divisible by 9. Now for your example, 3,060. So 3 plus 0 plus 6 plus 0 is equal to 9. Now 9 is a multiple of 9. So this number is said to be, that is 3060, is divisible by 9. Same way, next we have divisibility test for 10. In 10, if the units place is only 0, 0 should be there, not 5. So if the unit place is 0, then the number is said to be divisible by 10. Here for example 660. So the unit place is 0. Supposing I take 20, the unit place is 0. So if the unit place is 0, then only this number is said to be divisible by 10. Next we have divisibility test for 11. Now here, if the difference of the sum of the digits of the odd and even places, or either the difference of the digits at alternate places, is either 0 or 11, then the number is said to be divisible by 11. Now here I have taken an example, 10,824. Now here the odd places. Now first here we will take the sum of odd places. Now that is, now odd places is 4, 8 and 1, or the alternate places. So 4 plus 8 plus 1 is equal to 13. Now the sum of the even places. That is 2 and 0. So 2 plus 0 is equal to 2. Now the difference of the odd and the even places. So difference is equal to 13 minus 2 is equal to 11. So after the difference we get 11. So therefore this number, that is 10,824, is divisible by 11. So either this way, by the difference, if the number is either 11 or 0, then that number is said to be divisible by 11. So up till here, you have, I hope you have understood all the tests for divisibility, what I have explained to you today.